without your realizing it. Images you've posted online could be feeding a powerful facial recognition algorithm, often used by law enforcement.
It's over 3 billion photos with faces in the database, and it's all from open source internet. So any kind of website, CNN.com or mugshot websites, news sites, social media, you name it.
A company called Clearview AI has the largest known facial recognition database of images in the US, larger than the FBI's. It includes images scraped from social media sites like Facebook, YouTube, even Venmo. The algorithm isn't looking for your face only in the photos you've posted. It can find your face in other people's public photos too. The company says that's how a person accused of sexually abusing a child was identified.
They found him in the background of someone else's Instagram page, in the gym, you know, in the mirror.
Clearview's algorithm uses artificial intelligence, or AI, to identify people by mapping a person's unique facial features, like the nose or the distance between your eyes.
It will find the features that stay the same across age and color and like lighting and things like that.
Clearview says their app is now only available to law enforcement. Users upload an image with a case number, and the algorithm searches through billions of images for a match. Matches come up in seconds, with links to web pages.
And we're always, because we're crawling the web, folding back in the data that's out there into retraining an algorithm. You know, the larger data set we get, the more accurate it is over time as well.
But collecting and storing biometric data from online photos has raised concern. Canada called Clearview AI's app illegal, a violation of privacy rights, and ordered Canadian faces removed from the photo database. And the use of the technology is being challenged in the US, in Illinois, and in California. But Clearview is becoming increasingly mainstream for law enforcement, and the technology was used to help track down the January 6th Capitol rioters. The day after the riot, the company reported a 26% increase in searches.
So you get all these pictures that have been submitted from the public to the FBI's tip site, and it has to be compared against a database to get potential matches.
More than 400 people have been charged with crimes related to the January 6th attack. Rioters were likely dropping digital breadcrumbs with every move they made. Crowdsourced tips, location data, and surveillance footage have all helped law enforcement understand who was where on January 6th.
So many people were live streaming and taking photos. You know, hey, we can figure out who you are pretty easily with the technology that exists.
Clearview says their large data set is part of what makes the algorithm work so well. The company also says that facial recognition software should be a tool in an investigation, but not the only evidence for a criminal identification. But it's not always clear to the public which law enforcement agencies are using the technology and how they're using it.
The technology is pretty good, but it's still not suitable to say this is positively this person. You still have to have a human look at it and say this is a match. And even then, you still have to go out and do some more legwork and further confirm that your match is in fact who you think it is.
Many facial recognition systems have gender, age, and race biases, and often misidentify people of color. And critics are concerned about the technology exacerbating existing inequalities.
So artificial intelligence has the veneer of being objective, has the veneer of being at arm's length from human bias, but it is far from that. There's always a human element in the creation of these methodologies and these automated decision systems. And we have been very concerned about the inputs into these systems that often produce racially discriminatory results.
Clearview's co-founder claims their technology's identifications are more accurate than eyewitnesses.
I think that it can minimize mistakes, minimize misidentifications. The technology has far surpassed the human eye now in terms of accuracy.
And then there's the issue of privacy. A full embrace of the technology could potentially mean the end of anonymity in any location within view of a camera lens.
There are some potentially significant benefits for facial recognition technology, things like finding missing people or being able to use in law enforcement purposes to catch, for example, people that are dangerous that need to be found very quickly. But in order to recognize those benefits, we have to sacrifice almost everything in terms of privacy. Otherwise, those tools aren't going to be effective for their stated purposes. We have to sort of relinquish control over name-face databases so that all of our face prints are stored. We have to agree to being consistently surveilled in public all the time. And once we've done that, that's when the potential for abuse is at its highest for this technology.
There's been fairly widespread support for efforts to track down the Capitol rioters. But civil rights advocates have raised concerns about broader use of this kind of artificial intelligence.
I think anyone who cares about the future of our democracy will understand that we must have absolute and complete accountability at all levels for the attack on the Capitol. That said, what we don't want to see is the January 6th attack being used as a predicate for increased surveillance of Black communities, Brown communities, Muslim communities, and other communities that have been subject to this extensive and unwarranted surveillance over time.
Often we turn to technologies to try to solve hard social problems, hard political problems, because it's almost easier just to ask a technology to solve it for us, right? And instead, I think it's time to really ask the harder political questions. Are our rules appropriate? Can we achieve the same level of protection and serve the values that we want to serve with our existing tools? Is it really just a matter of not wanting to enforce them?